The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
You gotta be the man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 3729288. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 3729288. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you download and install it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
I knew I'd see her around. I'd be at some party. She'd show up and I'd be walking out. Across some parking lot. Hiding behind her sister, I'd look up. She'd be at the red light beside me in that white Maxim with the sticker on the back. I'd act like I didn't see her. But we'd play at the same pumps, flip through the same stations, and slow down for the same curves, run around with the same crowd. But we just needed some time. She could get on with her life and I'd get on with mine. Thought I would be fine, but maybe not. I knew she'd find a way to get over me. But I never thought she would get down with somebody I know. I guess that's just how it goes when you break up in a small town. I see our friends and they put on a show like they don't want me to know. So they give me the go around. But there's only so many streets, so many lights. Where it's like I can't even leave my house. Should've known all along you gotta move and move on when you break up in a small town. While I guess they were keeping it low-key, but now it's like these county lines closing in on me. I see them everywhere together, and it's hitting a little too close to home. She's so far gone, but she didn't go far. She was over me before the grass grew back where she used to park her car. She's leaving those same marks in someone else's yard, someone else's arms, right down the road. And I never thought she would get down with somebody I know. I guess that's just how it goes when you break up in a small town. I see our friends and they put on a show like they don't want me to.
to know, so they give me the go around. But there's only so many streets, so many lights, where it's like I can't even leave my house. Should've known all along, you gotta move and move on when you break up in a small town. Sometimes and I see you sitting there with him, and I wanna jump out, I wanna fight, I wanna say that guy, but I can't, it's my fault, and I let her go. I never thought that she would get down with somebody I know. I guess that's just how it goes when you break up in a small town. I see our friends and they put on a show like they don't want me to know, so then give me the go around. But there's only so many streets, so many lights, I swear it's like I can't even leave my house. Should've known all along, you gotta move and move on when you break up in a small town.
Got me. I can't get Paintless either out of my head or off my mind. It has everything to do with how I've blown up and becoming the biggest Paintless fan that you will hear on YouTube. I put up a video series on Paintless because I think it's very apparent that Paintless is in a position to take over. She's obviously been very impressive. I've come away from reviewing Paintless being very impressed with everything she's done, and this is why I've been throwing up these video blogs on Paintless, because I want to make more people aware of who Paintless is, because I think we have way too much emphasis on the same three or four Disney stars all the time. It's either about a Sabrina Carpenter, if not Sabrina Carpenter, Dove Cameron, Olivia Holt, Roland Blanchard, and I think that she's been overshadowed for far long enough because she's really in a position to take over. I want to hear something musically also from Paintless, because I think the focus is just on her being an actress for Disney and being one of the more unpredictable actresses that we have seen on a series like Bunked, and I think this is really the chance for her to break out. Musically, we could probably hear more from Paintless, and we'd probably be having more told to us about who Paintless is as a personality, because we really don't know that much about someone like a Paintless. When I first saw an altercation between herself and Debbie Ryan on Jesse a number of years ago, I said, this is really a character that you can do a lot with if ever given the chance to be on her own TV series. And years after I said that, you know, here we go with this series, Bunk. Bunk comes from out of nowhere, and now we have a character like Emma being portrayed by Paintless in the starring role of the series Bunk, where Jesse left us with. And I think that now we're going to get the answer to these questions, whether or not we're going to be seeing Paintless have a very promising future with something like Disney. But I remember that altercation between herself and Debbie Ryan. So if ever Debbie Ryan is given credit for having done anything, it's obviously paving the road to success for people like Paintless and the remnants of the cast of Jesse to have futures for themselves on Disney, like Debbie Ryan had paved for her a number of years ago. So if ever Debbie Ryan is given credit for doing anything, it's obviously paving the road to success not only for Paintless, but everybody else who was a part of the cast of Jesse. If you have not seen Bunked, you've got to check this series out, because the fullest potential of the remnants of the cast of Jesse is really shining through, especially the potential that goes with someone like Paintless. It's not really hard to figure out why I've become the biggest Paintless fan you will hear on YouTube these days, because of everything that Paintless has going on for her. And like I said, I'd love to hear an EP, a single, an album dropping from Paintless, even if we just heard one single from Paintless, because we have a lot of people who are multi-talented, never given the chance to show us what these multi-talents are. And we always hear about the Selena Gomez's or the Demi Lovato's of the world who are multi-talented, both as singers and actresses. But I think that someone like a Paintless really just needs that opportunity to really break through and show us what she's capable of having done. And this is why I've been throwing up all these video blogs on Paintless over the last few weeks, in the last several weeks on my YouTube channel, because I'm trying to make more people aware, obviously, to who Paintless is, because a lot of people tell me in conversations they don't know who the Dove Camerons are, they don't know who the Roland Blanchards are, and they don't know who the Paintless are. And my response always is, where have you been the last 2 or 3 years? Because shows like Girl Meets World and Bunked have blown up. Now, Bunked is still relatively new, but if you've heard anything about Jesse over the years, obviously it's a series where Jesse has left us, and Bunked picks up right where Jesse left us off with the Ross kids checking out of the penthouse and going to Camp Kiwaka for unpredictable times and Unpredictable Summers. This is going to be a series that you're going to see a number of seasons for and a number of episodes for. It may not last as long as what Jesse did, but after the following that Jesse left us with, I think Abunked is going to answer a lot of questions that we had from the series finale of Jesse. I think there's a lot that goes with this series and a lot of potential from all the cast members that we're going to be seeing on this show. We're also in line for guest appearances on Bunk from probably shows that we've seen in the past, which makes it more exciting for me as a fan of a show like Bunk, because I always look for these guest appearances from people that we probably haven't seen in a really long time. And I think that one of the biggest things to be highlighted from this show, Bunk, is that we're going to be seeing more from Peyton List. Obviously, the pressure was on Peyton List because she's in the starring role of this series. But I remember the altercation that she had with Debbie Ryan on Jesse, like I just spoke on there. And I said, you know, there's a lot of potential that goes with someone like Peyton List portraying this character, Emma, because this character is obviously in a position to take over. If you're looking for an answer to someone like a Dove Cameron or a Ross Lynch or even a Laura Moreno, I think the answer obviously lies with Peyton List because of just how unpredictable she has shown if she can be on time from a show like Jesse, and from how unpredictable she's been on this series Bunk thus far. Even though we have minimal episodes and minimal production of this series thus far, there is still a long way to go for a series like this. I don't see it getting to a point of probably a Girl Meets World or a Living.